I love you. Oh. So, it is 10 years to the day that I did a show in a place called Nebworth. Yeah. In England. And I don't mean to blow my own trumpet or be a big head or an egoic person, but there were 135,000 people there each evening. They made a DVD. It was available in the shops. It sold out. They wrote about it in the Bible. It made me feel good. And I did this song there. It's called She's the One. You know this song? And before She's the One at Nebworth, I gave my microphone to a man in the audience, and he proposed to his then girlfriend, and in front of 135,000 people that had come to see me, he said, "Darling, I love you, and I always have, and I always will. Will you marry me?" And she said, "Yes." That was 10 years ago to this day. My management got hold of that couple. Unfortunately, they got divorced. It was really shit time for both of them. They blamed me, they're like Robbie Williams, the bastard. It didn't go well. Never mind, you win some, you lose some, eh? So, in this song, She's the One, which is my 13th favorite song that I've ever written. It goes, when you get to where you want to go, and you know the things you want to know, yeah. You're smiling. When you say what you want to see, and you know the way you want to play it, you feel so high on me. Okay, I ain't gonna lie. I can't reach that note. It's too high for me. But you ladies, you can reach that note. Ladies, will you sing that bit for me? And I'm going to dedicate this one tonight to Carl from Coventry. That's Carl, right? Yeah, okay. Carl from Coventry, you're such a tender lover. When we went down in the bed there, the mustache didn't get in the way. It felt real. I love you, Coventry. This is She's the One. Do you like my stage shoes? Are they fabulous? I was her. She was me. We were one. We were free.
If there's somebody calling me on,
God bless you. So ladies and gentlemen, this is the last show of the tour. The last show of 2013. And I stopped touring in 2006. And I thought that I'd retired in 2006. You know, I had a really weird year for one thing or another. I'm a bit strange and a bit mental. And at the end of that year, I went to rehab. That gives you an explanation what was going on with me. And I decided that I was never going to be a pop star again. I decided that I was never going to write songs or sing them or perform again. What a silly asshole I am. It's a good job I didn't tell anybody. So, then what happened was, I find a girlfriend, she became my wife, I fell in love, we got married. We had a baby. Teddy. She's here tonight, she's 11 months old, she's fucking incredible, you should see her. She's incredible. She looks just like me. And she dances and she sings and she's nearly saying things and she's just wonderful. And I also happen to find the most amazing band that I've ever had. All beautiful people, all really, really 100% behind me and 100% ready to entertain you and 100% ready to take this party all over Europe, which we've done. And I was worried before the tour started that, you know, I'm a bit older and fatter, and I was worried that maybe I'm not as good, and then I was worried that maybe you were not as good. Yes, right, motherfuckers. It's not all part on Steve time. I thought you might be shit too. But you weren't. You weren't at all. And I felt the love come up on stage like I never have before. I'm a bit older and a bit more mature now, and this is the best job in the world. I love show business, and I love making you happy, and I love performing for you. And I got the best life. I'm a very, very blessed man. I'm incredibly lucky. I got the love and support of my wife, and I got the love and support of my daughter. I have the love and support of the best band in the world behind me. And I have the best... I can't call you fans, it seems disrespectful. I just want to call you friends. And I have the best friends supporting me. You're here for a laugh. You're here to sing back to me. You're here to be entertained. And I feel the love beaming back at me, and I truly have the best job in the world. And I hope that you come back, and I hope I get to entertain you again sooner rather than later. So tonight I'm going to dedicate the next song to my wonderful loving band and singers and brassies and whatever you do, Jerry, whatever that is you do, yeah. And my wonderful wife, who's my best mate, and I love her to bits, and she just gives me the, you know, I know it's cliche, but she's my rock. She gives me everything I need to go and do this job and enjoy it. And this is for my wife. I love you, baby. Sing with me. This is Angels. Thank you to the crew. Thank you, everyone, for putting this show together. God bless.
I see the way. There's an angel contemplating my fate. Do you know the places where we go when we're gray?